have no idea. Okay, I'm seeing something. This is a preview. So if I click go live, I'm live now. I'm technically live now. Okay. We have a second viewer. Let's see if this is working as intended. If you guys can see and hear me, just go ahead and say anything in the chat. Okay, there's three viewers now. Okay. Anyways, this was a little different, this new YouTube live stream thing. I guess they're really pushing that switch over to the new studio. Okay, but we're gonna go ahead and just get started with today's stream. So hello, thank you for joining me. If you're watching this segment, you're most likely in the playback. But I just wanted to start off by saying down in the description below, I'm gonna play an album here that I recently purchased. It's a great album. I really love it. Really soothing and relaxing, kind of. I'm into the elevator music, so I like some background music. I'll go ahead and start playing that now. But the link to that album is down in the description below. It's really reasonably priced, and it's great music if you're into kind of that style of music. So I'm going to go ahead and play that. Find it in the description. Other than that, you guys can join me over on Discord. I haven't been as active as I probably should be on the Discord, but it's a great place if you have any questions regarding penmanship. There's a lot of very, very experienced and proficient penmen on there who are willing to offer their experience and advice. So I highly recommend you go check that out. One thing, I just remembered that I should probably invite somebody to that because they told me to invite them. But the link's in the description down below. So if you're interested in the Discord and being a part of that, you're welcome to join. You can just follow the link down below. And again, if you like the music, the link is in the description. I'm trying to get those guys to sponsor me. If we can get enough sales for them in the music, because it's like 60 songs for I think the minimum donation's $4, but I always shoot them like $20 per album because I love the music and I want them to keep doing it. So but anyways, if you guys are interested, you can find the music in the description. And let's see, what else do we have going on that's new? Well, things at the museum are going great. I've been wanting to do this exhibition at the museum where we would bring penmen from potentially all over the country if we can, and show their collection and also have them do lectures around what it's like to be a penman today. Oh yeah, something new is I got this pen back. I don't know if you guys remember this pen. Is the autofocus on? I can't tell. Maybe it's not going to do it. Anyways, we got this pen back. This is the Visconti Homo Sapien. And I just had the nib reground by John over at nibs.com. And it came back writing so beautifully. I actually really enjoy this pen now. If you guys remember from any of my older videos, the pen used to be a medium nib and it was a very fat and juicy nib. And now it's a nice extra fine and still very wet nib. So I can do all my penmanship practice with this pen. So I'm really happy about that. It is an awesome pen. Yeah, so I thought I might buy a new pen this year, because last year I didn't buy any pens. And so I thought, maybe I'll buy one this year. And then I thought, no, you know what I should do is just pay to have this nib reground so I can enjoy this pen. And he did a great job. And shout out to Dave, DJ Calligraphy on Instagram. I think it's DJ Calligraphy. He recommended that I go to John because I was going to go to somebody else. It was a little cheaper and I thought, it's just regrinded nib, it'll do a good job. And he's like, no, don't do it. Just go to John. John's the only guy who really knows what he's doing. And he told me some horror stories about going to other people. And I thought, oh, might as well. It's a little bit more money, but maybe it's worth it. And it was also a very long wait. I think it took me 3 months to get the pen back because he has a large queue. But it was worth the wait. I love the pen. So if you're ever interested in getting a pen reground, I highly recommend you go to John at nibs.com. I think the Instagram's like the real nibs.com or something like that. I don't know, maybe this thing won't focus. I'm just gonna leave it alone. Okay. So today is May 26th. Are we on the 26th already? Wow. May 26th. Live stream. And then I titled this episode today, the Ambidextrous Penman, or Ambidextrous Penman, something like that. Let's see if I can rotate this around here. Oh, look at that. Okay. Probably close the window.
close that window.
Desk is somewhat of a mess. Just paper everywhere. So this style of writing where you go back and forth across the page is referred to as Boustrophedonian writing, because the Greeks of antiquity would write this way, flipping all their characters around, going forward and backwards. Really amazing how well tuned this nib is now that I've got it back from nibs.com, because my left hand writes significantly slower than the right, and you can see how the lines are darker. Like, I think that, no, it's not still wet, but the lines are a little darker, so the ink is having more time to pull up. scratch paper. So hopefully once I write something, it'll focus up. Okay. Just realized I don't have the chat open. Oh, I don't know. Okay. Oh, I had something exciting happen this week. I guess it's not that exciting, but it was a good feeling. I used to teach a brain training class on the campus that the museum is on. So where I work now, it's really close to where I used to teach that class. And we had this student come into the museum, and I just happened to be at the entrance at the time. And she recognized me, and she was one of my students from back, this was in 2015 when I was teaching that class. And so I asked her if she still did any of the mirror image handwriting or any of that. And she said that she did and that she still found it very helpful. And I thought, wow, that's so cool that I did something that is still affecting people's lives. 5 years later? No, 4 years later. And then also we did a lot of memory exercises in that brain training class. And she said she still uses the brain memory exercises and that she feels as if her memory has gotten better now. She takes all her notes in cursive now, which is awesome. That's so cool to hear. So, it did make an impact on some people's lives. I would imagine that most people, if they took a class and they were taught how to write in mirror image, it's not something that they would let go, because it's a kind of a novel thing. So you're not seeing. Okay, there we go. Thank you. If you can read the mirror writing, translate it into the chat. Let's see who can get it right. My left-handed writing, it always comes out very consistent. I mean, the right-handed is not too bad. There's some variance in the line. You see they're getting a little further apart here at the end. But the left hand looks pretty spot on. Does seem to, not too much though. I mean, it does tilt a little bit down towards the left side of the page, but in general, it's pretty good. Always impressed by that. on the nib that keeps bothering me. To the end of the page there. Into the box. Let's see what we have here. Scrap paper. Could change it up a little bit. See, can we see everything okay? Is practicing writing with the non-dominant hand a good exercise for the brain? Oh, that is that your guess for what it said in mirror image? Or are you asking that question? If you're asking the question, I would say yes, it's a good exercise for the brain. B is a very hard letter. using up these scratch sheets of watercolor paper. Shading is such an interesting break of the flow. You gotta find a way to make it work. I don't know. Have I been here for 1 hour already? Is that correct? My goodness, time flies. 11:30. I don't see the elapsed time anymore. Oh, there it is. Yeah, 59 minutes and 50 seconds. Holy cow. That is impressive how time just flies when you're having fun. Got ink all over the wrong places here. Let's see here. Can never tell. Okay. I'm in frame. It's an ugly pee. I should really probably pull out exemplars before I do this, but I'm just trying to have fun. It's not good, but it's not bad either. Tighter. Not on camera. Thank you. This nib, I think, is dying. We can do those three cards. to do O's. Nib is getting sticky. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you found it somewhat entertaining, maybe motivating, maybe got you to sit down and do some writing. If you're watching on playback and you've made it this far, many thanks to you. Call it right there and then, so that this video isn't too intimidating to anybody. All right, thanks for watching, guys. Y'all have a good one. Take care.